Okay, so have all of you guys read through the method and you've seen that we're going to be using alpha, beta, and gamma?
Ooh.
Gamma.
Right. Okay, so here's what this is.
Geiger counter.
On it beeps.
So yes, it does indeed say Geiger counter.
Yep, he was so in Chernobyl.
It's towards a thing.
And it beeps.
And indeed, it beeps.
Yay.
Depending on whether or not it's detected radiation. So
it just always beeps. It's just like a beep. It's just a clock that makes a beep.
It says,
beep. So you can see, and everyone's got goggles on. Good. Except for Jack. So you can tell, even if there's...
They're behind your computer, right here. Here.
Oh, yeah, she's...
So you guys can tell, even right now, even though it's pointed away from the sources, that you're still getting some counts on the radiation.
Background
radiation, yes.
If you put it near the telephone, you'll get more.
Okay. Or the microwave.
The box, you'll get more, too. Okay.
Uh-oh.
Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, you got me just after me.
Radioactive.
Okay, so we'll start with alpha.
That was so bad.
American.
Okay. So we've got polonium-210.
Oh.
No, they emit very small amounts because you can actually have them in a school.
Ooh.
Stronger or weaker than next way?
So let's see. You should be able to hear it as well, how much it emits when we turn it on. Not very much. That's it. Okay. So that was a count of about 13, which is hardly anything at all. Now, we're going to put this lowly piece of paper in front of it.
It gets higher. I'm fixing the focus.
Oh, thank you.
Now, why would it have to go up?
Yeah, that was actually higher.
There
you go. Yeah, so we have radioactive paper. This was actually the one I was using yesterday when I was testing the experiment, so there you go.
Actually?
Fine, yeah.
Oh.
Okay, if the paper's going to be uncooperative, let's use the most massive sheet of lead we've got.
24? What?
Yeah, that's also more than the resting radiation. It's
the radioactive lead.
Question mark?
That's actually more than a sample on its own.
Yeah. This is going well.
Yeah.
Well, you're going to have a pretty good
loop
reel there, Spencer. It could be the box next to it. Yeah, let's do that.
Yeah.
The box.
Yeah, that's stopping it. What does that have in it?
Okay, let's try that one again.
That sounds promising.
Yes.
What happened?
Should
not be beating
at all.
No, okay, so that is more than I would expect. That was four counts. Now let's take this away.
That's more.
Okay. So that's more. So yes, as expected, and not at all on the blooper reel, there were more counts when there was no giant block of lead in the middle than when there were less.
Wow.
Incredible. Okay. And you can measure how far it will go through air before it'll basically be background radiation. And when I tried it yesterday, it was about 2 centimeters. So, yes. Not very good. So, we can see how many we get here.
If you held it against the goggles, you'd be fine.
We should have done this on an open day and invite people in.
Yes, you would. Don't try it.
So, can I depart?
You've got a music lesson.
You're just like, are you actually doing it? Oh, good on you.
Okay.
That's alright.
Hey, why don't we get a phone?
Doesn't matter.
Are we just doing this for the
No. I want to see like Scotty P do it or something.
Okay. Thanks, fellas. So,
drive off.
So yeah, now that that's had to go through a few centimeters of air, it's actually back to background radiation level. So again, these are samples you see in a school, but no matter. In fact, I'm going to try something else. I'm going to see what the penetration is across a ruler.
Ooh.
I'm breaking all the rules.
Damn it. Damn it feels good to be a gangster.
Too much sauce.
Okay.
Shish one short.
There you go. This is actually doing a better job than the lead, so this is. Yeah. That was 4 counts.
What's that? Wall made of?
Wood.
Obviously, it's made of lead.
Yes.
It's better than lead. There you go.
Dead for lead.
Super lead.
Well, lead in your pencil.
Some of the doors at the ANU, the big particle accelerator, they use like wax made out of paraffin.
Why is that?
Interesting.
Just a.
So, if you have long chain particles that are about the same mass, like think of hitting a billiard ball, right? If it's the same mass, then it'll be hit away really easily.
Oh, true.
If it's not a root. Okay. Next is our beta sample.
What's that for?
Lead.
So, as you can see, quite a bit of lead in there. Yes.
How do you dispose of radioactive stuff?
So, basically put it in a big lead canister and bury it deep underground.
Yeah, like Billy Griffin. Just kill all the cop.
Okay. Let's see what the counts are like.
That's a smart idea.
So be out of Futurama and just fire it into space. I hope it doesn't come back to Earth in 1,000 years.
Can we actually call someone? Oh.
Oh. Are we
dead? Okay. He was like, I was not expecting that.
Suddenly regretting touching that one now.
Wait, what is it?
That was a gamma source, was it?
That was a beta. Let's move that one away.
Let's put that away.
Sure, let's try that one.
Okay, well that works considerably better than the others.
Yes.
We tried jamming the phone.
If you don't value your phone,
because the camera should show like my phone's a little bit of a piece of shit.
Can I actually donate my phone?
Let's start again. Don't use your phone, Spencer.
Oh, like it's literally a Sony, so I.
Oh, Spencer, you touch the screen, so that's.
Okay, so this is a beta emitter. So what do you think will happen if we put a bit of paper in the middle?
No, it doesn't. Oh, it blocks a little bit.
It's actually stopping a fair bit, but it's still going through.
What was the count of the first time, sir?
It was about 3,000.
Jeez.
What's that?
And that was about 800.
What's that similar to? 3,000.
Count from over there.
Bananas.
We could try it.
Okay,
let's try it from over near Paul's. Let's see how much radiation. Basically nothing. Good. It's alright, I'm taking all the bullets for you, fellas.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so that was basically background. That one.
It's a normal.
What about
let's see what it's like from 30 centimeters away.
Is the skeleton going to live?
It's still a nuke.
I don't think we are.
So a Geiger count is measured in ticks.
So from 30, well, it's in counts and it makes a noise every time it makes a count.
Yeah.
So that was about 30 centimeters away and that was barely above background. Let's say 40.
So when the beta particles hit that lead, what happens to it? Is it just absorbed? Or is it reflected, or what is it?
Yeah, they'll basically recoil off the material, so they may be captured or they may bounce off somewhere else.
Oh, okay.
Okay. I think we can put that one back. Okay. And lucky last, let's get one of the gammas going.
Oh, this is gamma. Oh, this is scary.
So gamma should go the most.
Wait, so can you communicate with us? Well, communicate how gamma radiation
is. Oh, jeez.
Is that gamma?
Yeah.
Oh, that's true. Alright, I'm good. Is that the law of communication? Gamma waves?
Gamma waves?
Yeah.
Yeah, they would have been most of...
Very dangerous one.
Well, I mean, a gamma ray... slash a gamma wave, slash a photon. Yes, it's on the EM spectrum. That's basically the gist of it. Okay.
There we go.
How about from over here?
So what was the gamma wave on that?
That was about 600.
So that's less than the beta.
Beta, yeah.
Although that's just depending on the sample. So they have a different lifetime on them. So like this one says it will decay. Its half-life is 28.6 years, so every 28.6 years, you'll have half of the material you did when you started.
That's insane.
Whereas, yeah. So generally, the higher the half-life is, then the less it will emit. So,
so
this one
the half-life of like one
is 5.2 years. So that will decay a little bit faster. I'd say the one we were using before was quite a bit less.
That box looks quite old. You look old. Oh, wait.
So this is about 10 centimeters away. Still a fair bit above background, that's 40 counts.
Let's go. He's a bit saturated.
Yeah, saturated.
Yeah, so how much radiation does
this
skeleton
have? This guy?
Yeah.
Well, who knows how they got like that? Maybe it was from this kid.
Too many gamma rays.
Say about 30.
So do you have a stronger gamma one?
If there is, I'd rather not use it.
So the plastic glass.
I know, these will do all the good in the world to protect me against gamma.
Yeah.
Okay. Just about 35. This should be where it's about back to back on radiation.
The survivors of this cancellation.
Okay, so as you can see, you guys are all sitting more than 30 centimeters away, so you're fine. I'm just taking all the shots for you. I live to give, that's what I do. Now,
you come to school tomorrow with like an extra eye or something.
Okay.
Oh, I'm sorry, Monday.
So that's a few mils of lead. You can tell it's still doing quite a bit through that. So that was 112 compared to this. Yes.
So the
count without the lead was 174, with it was 112.
Build over.
So this one is a whole centimeter of lead. Let's see what that does. Okay, so that's back to 63.
Oh.
So how thick does it have to be?
Thea.
Okay, let's try.
Bad me, Sam. Bad me.
With two C's? Okay.
Oh my god.
Man, she's thick.
How old do you think I am?
How old?
I use the internet too. Okay, that's 19. So there's still some getting through.
So if you're really thick, so you can survive gamma radiation.
Proven theory.
Yes.
She.
Did you just assume gender?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Actually, I'm pretty sure that's not figure out. It's clearly Apache attack
helicopter. I'm pretty sure we figure out.
Okay, that's 14.
Yeah, I'm sure you
know. Girls have two extra bones?
What extra bones?
Really?
It's getting from the side.
So,
like,
it connects the pelvis, so it can get bigger.
Lol, sucks to be a pelvis.
You could be having
a
teeth on
the. It
goes
all
better
than
the
health.
Okay. Okay, that's 13. I think you get the idea, right?
Yeah.
All of this lead is not stopping the radiation completely.
Unfortunately.
It's not most of it, but not all of it.
Is there any chance the lead is slightly
contaminated?
Yeah, absolutely. From the amount of times it's been irradiated to stop radiation. Yeah, I remember when this was a demo in my high school chemistry class. The teacher had a similar moment where he put the lead in front of the counter and was like, oh, I guess it's been in there being irradiated for so long by the samples it's trying to protect you from. Which absolutely can happen.
That's unfortunate. So indeed. The lead has been essentially turned into an emitter as well?
It's been irradiated so much it's actually radioactive.
It's not always protected by lead, but it's not
right. You can stop now.
Sorry. Right.
I know.